And finally, the closing act of the evening. He is a software engineer by trade. He is a thinker on the edges by choice, I suppose. He became superhuman, and he will tell you how you can be just that. Please welcome Krystian Paszkiewicz.
Hi, so my name is Krystian Paszkiewicz, and I'll be saying how to become superhuman. Of course, every superhuman has a weakness, right? And mine is, of course, public speaking. So let's start. Why really we would like to be superhuman, right? Well, maybe because we can. It's simple and it's affordable. And, well, when you look at the research on the web, it's even fast. So why not if we have this possibility? So what superpowers can we have? It's, for example, let's say super strength, right? I mean, we don't have super strength because we don't like go to the gym. I mean, nobody spends several hours a day just to have super strength, right? But what if I tell you can have super strength having just 10-minute workout a day, which will total to 1 hour a week? Well, you can. There's one guy called Alexander Faliv that found out after researching 8 years of his training day by day that he can have amazing results just by combining three basic exercises. And what are the results? 50 kilograms added to your max in each of the three power lifts. Okay, so I said it's easy. Yeah, it is. What Alexander says is that you can have one lift per workout, stretch and get out. So your total time in the gym, max 10 minutes, right? Okay, so big muscles. Big muscles doesn't really equal strength. I mean, you can have big and weak or really strong and not really big. I remember what my girlfriend told me once that several years ago that she doesn't feel secure with me because I'm slim, even though I exercise a lot. So how can you fix that? Well, just find any program. Just three simple rules for this program. Perform one set to failure, 5 seconds up, 5 seconds down, and, this is the results. There's a Colorado experiment that one guy in the University of Colorado spent 28 days working out, eating without any supplements, and gained 28 kilo of muscle mass and lost 8 kilo of fat. Okay, that's fast. So amazing speed. Okay, everyone wants to be fast, right? But also, if you want to run ultra marathon, you cannot really train 20 hours a week. So here comes Brian McKenzie, guy who trains 6.5 hours a week and runs ultra marathons that have 100 miles. So, yeah, that's exactly it. He found out that he can train like 400-meter sprints with 2 minutes in between and gain enough endurance and enough speed to run for the next 20 hours on ultra marathon. Okay, the last thing I think is brain power and sleep. So we are strong, we are fast, we are big, right? So now brain power. Brain power, we don't need to really to maximize our brain power. Our brain is already awesome, right? We just need to learn how to use it. So let's say more time to play with our brain. So how to hack sleep? Everyone of us probably sleeps around, I don't know, 8 hours a day, right? But what if we could sleep just 4 hours, 6 hours, or maybe just 2 hours? Here where polyphasic sleep goes into business. And as you can see, actually you can sleep less and have, well, the same effects. Okay, so what's really this is used for is, well, you need to decide. We are not really good with advice, right? Most of you forget everything I said till the after party. So, but please don't. Why? Because it's important. You can do awesome things, and you just need to find a reason why you cannot fail. So, if you find this reason, the next thing you need to know is you need to self-experiment. Not everything I told you will work for you the same way. It will work better or worse. Please, if you will do anything in your life, get a journal.
check how strong are you, how big your muscles are, how long can you run, how alert you are after little sleep or just 2 hours of sleep. Okay, and at the end, I just want to say a quote by one of the American authors that, you know, you can be miserable or you can be strong, but, well, it takes the same effort. Thank you.